In this video, we'll go over how to select colors and use the color popover in Procreate 4. Over here in the top corner is the color that I'm currently using, black. If you tap on it, you get a color popover where you can choose your color. It uses a hue, saturation, value color disk. Each color is made up of a hue, the base color, the saturation, strength of a color, and the value, how dark or bright the color is. Combine all three and you'll get a color. Now let's try this in Procreate. The ring of color is the hue here. Hue is the base or pure color. All different shades and tints of red have the same hue. If you tap on the ring and drag it around the ring, you're changing the hue. Also, the color in the circle will change. The circle represents the values and saturation. Saturation is how pure the color is, or the strength of the color that is represented by going left or right. Tap inside the circle and drag to the right to increase saturation. That is paint out of the tube, pure color, all pure red pigments here. That's as red as you can get in this program. Now, if you go left, you're decreasing saturation. You can imagine you're mixing the paint with white paint. The red color gets weaker and less until you get no pigments, just black, white, or gray. And that brings us to value. Value is the darkness or brightness. If you take away the hue and saturation, you'll get a gray scale. It's like looking at a black and white photo. In the circle, if you drag up, you're increasing value. That means your color is getting lighter or brighter. If you drag down, you're decreasing the value until you get to black. Here's another color wheel. I just tapped on the classic down here at the bottom. Here, see, you have your hue, saturation, and value. See, works the same way. I like the disc better because it helps me think about color. Now that you know how the color disc works, when you're playing around with it, your mind will also be thinking about how values and saturation work. That's a good thing. Try picking a different color and test out different brushes. Do you remember how we talked about the brushes in the previous video? Brushes also react differently to color. Some just go over it and will replace another color. Some changes the color as it goes over it. And some mix more, like paint, changing color and changing the texture. Pretty cool, right? A cool trick you can do is tap and drag the color out and let go. It will do what's called a fill, like this. Notice it replaces whatever color you drop it on with your new color. It will replace it until it meets an edge. That's where the color changes. So if you do all your line work first, then you can fill it in with this technique. There's also another way to choose color without opening up your color popover here. If you hold the modify button and tap anywhere on the canvas, an eyedropper loop will appear. The current color is the bottom half and the top half is the new color. Drag around to pick a color from your canvas and let go. Now the new color is selected. Pretty handy. Speaking of handy, you can also bring up the eyedropper by using one finger. Just tap and hold anywhere on the canvas with your finger and wait for the eyedropper loop to appear. There's actually a lot you can do with your finger and using gestures, but we'll go over that in the next video. Okay, so review time. The ring is your hue. The circle or disc in the middle is the saturation going left to right. Increase saturation for more pure color. Decrease saturation and you're reducing the strength of the color. Drag up and down for the value. Increase value for more brightness, almost getting white. And decrease value for more darkness until you get to black. Color is a huge topic that I'm still trying to learn. But if you can think about hue, saturation, and value as you're picking colors, then you already made a big step. If it's confusing, don't worry. I had trouble wrapping my head around it even after finishing art school. Okay, so maybe I wasn't the best student. But color is a lot more complicated than you might think, but I encourage you to play around. Try using different hues of similar saturation, or just one hue, but change the saturation and values, or try drawing with only values and making a black and white drawing. So that's it for using the color popover and selecting color in Procreate. In my next video, I'll go over using gestures. This is a series I wanted to make for my kids to give them a foundation in digital painting. I'm also hoping it's useful for anyone who's an absolute beginner. I also produce stories for kids on YouTube, and I like to think they're for the young and young at heart. So be sure to subscribe so you don't miss them. Thanks.